Hello, good evening. Hi, Dan.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm all right. It's sunny.
It's sunny at this time. Well, it is up there for you. It's a bit shitty up here.
Oh yeah, no, it's northern.
Ooh. Right, so we are here to talk about WrestleMania weekend.
Yeah.
It was not a bad weekend, was it?
It was a wonderful weekend.
It was a beautiful weekend.
Beautiful weekend.
In sunny Orlando. Fucking right, yeah. For some, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, obviously, what could you say? Everything about it was yeah.
Great. Yeah. I was angry, and I was happy, and I was sad, and I was everything, and yeah.
I say it's definitely been one of the best manias since 31. Definitely, it's been better than the last two.
Oh God, I think for myself it was better than 31.
Really?
Yeah, because 31 was we really liked it, or I really liked it anyway. I can't speak for you, but I really liked it because of the matches.
Yeah, the actual card
but
itself.
This came with more emotion and more reaction for me, and it had more of a connection with me on that level, and that's why it's topped.
Yeah,
31.
I'm not ignoring you. I'm just filling my pipe up.
That's all right.
That's where I ran off to while the titles were going on. I quickly ran downstairs to get my juice.
Once again, well prepared for a stream.
Well, when you text me to tell me what time we were doing it, I was actually out shopping.
Oh, well, you know. See, again, well prepared. See, I came straight home from work.
Yeah.
I've had my food.
Well,
changed.
I'm having my dinner after.
Right, so about 11 o'clock, yeah?
Yeah, about that. Sorry, she's having hers now. I'll have mine after. So, obviously, we had WrestleMania access. I think for the first time it's actually been a non-ticket affair. I noticed that. I saw a video on YouTube, I think it must have been from the actual WWE website as well. They followed TJ Perkins around. He went into the superstore that they had there.
Yeah.
And they actually sold out of Cruiserweight title belts. The only one they actually sold out of was the Cruiserweight ones.
Yeah.
But I did look at the price of them.
Oh yeah, God yeah, no, you'd never any normal
about $400 each.
Yeah, normal man on normal pay cannot convince.
But I think
other
if,
half.
I think if we go to Mania 1 year, we'll buy one.
Oh yeah, well if we have enough money to go to Mania, we have enough for one of those.
Well, exactly, yeah. Then obviously Friday night was the Hall of Fame ceremony.
Yes.
I'll tell you, did you watch it live?
I didn't watch it live, watched it the day after.
Yeah, same here. Yeah. It was very good.
I enjoyed it, yeah.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
I thought a bit of it was going to be boring, but it wasn't.
No, there was a lot of
Roll Express and that kind of part I thought would be a little bit.
There was a lot of good stories from back in the day, especially with Jim Cornette and things like that. That was he was a bit. He got more mental, I think, in his old age than he used to be.
Doesn't seem completely there.
No.
But anyway,
I'm sorry if my face crumples up. I've got a new juice. I'm about to try it. See what it's like. It's a menthol one. It smells really strong in the bottle.
Let's all pause for a minute while James.
That's nice. It's not as bad actually coming out of the pipe than it is out of the bottle.
It's nice you did the Brahma Bull as well.
Well, I only had one nostril. This one's slightly blocked. but yeah, I mean, obviously, Kurt was definitely the star of the show on that one. That was absolutely brilliant.
Shows he still doesn't care to be the stupid guy.
Well, exactly. I mean, he brought out the cowboy hat. He did his rap battle. He sung "I'm a Sexy Kurt," and then to top it all off with the two milk jugs at the end. That was just class. I'd love to say the fact that he rented that suit.
Yeah, he had two because his one at WrestleMania was either dry cleaned impeccably, or he had changed
his suit. Could you imagine him taking that back to the rental shop?
Yeah. No, what happened? Well, it'd be their own fault. They should know better.
Well, exactly. But no, Hall of Fame was good. Obviously, we will touch on for later dates on the next one. Saturday night NXT TakeOver. Yep. I didn't actually watch it. I actually missed it. Did you watch that?
No, I got the results, but I didn't watch it. I basically had a bit of a dodgy weekend, and then obviously I came back from work Monday, and because the pay-per-view was 5 hours, it took the entire evening up. That was a long
I watched it from kickoff, from 10 o'clock p.m. UK time,
yeah,
till Mania finished, and it was from about 10 o'clock till about 5:30.
Yeah. It's insane.
Yeah.
Length of time.
I don't even think they expected it to be that long, because on the actual schedule on the network itself, it said it was going to finish at 4:00. And then the runtime for the replay was going to start at 4:00. So obviously when she got up that morning to go to work, I wanted to show her something from Mania. I went to rewind it and got to the beginning of it, and it actually started the Brock Lesnar match.
Yeah,
because it clashed over.
Yeah, I think it was 5 hours and
it was about five and a quarter hours, I think it was.
When I saw the timer, because obviously I watched it, I didn't watch it live, so I've got it playing. I'm thinking, oh, I always usually check how long is it. And it obviously had the 5 hours, and I thought, oh, they've stuck like an after show or something.
Oh, yeah, no, it was the whole sometimes. Thing. Because that's what got me. I mean, yeah. I looked at it and I thought, it was just after the Orton and Wyatt match. I thought, hang on, we still got three matches to go.
Because I messaged you when I was watching it.
Yeah.
And I said, I've just reached Orton Bray, and I thought I was near the end. So I was telling you, like, how good the pay per view was. I completely forgot.
There's three matches to go.
After pissing Ross throughout. And yeah, it was a long. Yeah, it was long, but it was an
amazing pay per view. I mean, what we'll do, we'll start off with the kickoff show.
Yep.
Because I've got the matches on here. We didn't actually expect these to be on the kickoff show, but they end up being pushed over to it. So obviously, first was the cruiserweight title match, Neville versus Austin Aries. Neville ended up retaining that, but Austin Aries put on a great performance. I don't know if you saw the kickoff, any of the kickoff show.
A little bit.
He put on a great performance. I mean, the crowd were loving it. Even though being the first match and being in the kickoff show, the crowd were absolutely loving it. And it was a shame, obviously, that he didn't win. But Neville basically just showed him he is the king, really.
Yeah, it's fine. Austin's only just, you know, come in, so yeah. For him to win. I know, didn't we say we wanted Austin to win?
I think we said we wanted Austin to win, but it wouldn't have mattered if Neville won, because obviously the way he's shown as a heel, it embraces his character a lot more as a heel.
But there's a lot of things that, you know, we won't agree with, but the whole pay-per-view makes it all acceptable.
Yeah.
But no, Neville earned it for sure.
Definitely, yeah. Like, no questions. The Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Did you see any of that?
Highlights. A weird
ending, yes. Did you notice, though, that the fact of when... can't remember his name now.
Come on. It's fine. We can all wait for you.
Yeah, it's all right. I'm trying to think. Was it Jinder Mahal?
Yeah.
When he took Mojo out of the ring, and then he had that face off with what's his name? The NFL player. I can't remember his name now.
Well, I don't know either.
No, so exactly, NFL player. Yeah, the NFL player.
We're not American. No, exactly. Get over it, everyone.
He had a face-off with him and then obviously chucked his drink over him. He then climbed the barricade. Obviously, it's part of the storyline. But no one told a specific security guard woman who tried to throw him back over the barricade.
Yes.
And then all the referees came down and were trying to whisper to him, it's part of the storyline, let him through.
It's nice to know that, you know, outside my workplace, communication is shit as well.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
You know, things haven't been communicated well.
No, exactly.
I think that was probably the only real cock-up
out
of the whole thing.
Yeah,
I mean, Battle Royale is a big thing to logistically do anyway, like Royal Rumble. It's,
well, yeah, exactly.
You see people sitting there waiting and all this sort of thing, but
obviously, I mean, obviously with the interference of him as well, end up with Mojo taking it and becoming the fourth winner.
Mm-hmm.
I'm quite pleased for him actually. I mean, obviously, we wanted Strowman to win that, didn't we?
Yeah,
but I think what they were trying to show is anyone can win that now, because we've had the big people win it, we've had Big Show win it, we've had Cesaro, and we've had
my God, you!
I'm useless today, Baron Corbin.
Thank you. We've had
you're supposed to help me.
No, I like watching. I like being with the crowd, and sitting here and waiting.
So we've had the big people win it, and it's nice to see someone different win it for a change instead of the big guys. I mean, I know Mojo's not exactly spotted, but it's nice to see someone else win it. If you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then the last match on the kickoff show was actually for the IC title, Ambrose and Baron Corbin, and
surprised with that.
Yeah, I was actually. I think obviously when they realised how big this card was, they needed to kick another one down to the kickoff show.
Yeah, but that was fine, because what they left behind in WrestleMania was more. It wasn't title driven. It was feud driven.
Yeah.
Story driven.
Yeah.
And the IC title had no story linked to it at this point in time.
Not really.
And
it was just like a filler. Really,
it
wasn't
just
it?
Made sense to bring that down, because the rest of the pay per view was spot on.
Yeah.
Because they'd left it all up. So.
And obviously, and Ambrose retained that one as well.
He did.
It was also a good match. I mean, all three of their matches on that kickoff show were all good.
Mm.
Which made a change, because normally kickoff show matches are crap.
Yeah, pretty much any kickoff.
Yeah.
I mean, I still to this day, I don't think I've watched a whole one.
Mm.
I might go back and watch this one. But,
yeah, I'll say the WrestleMania kickoff show was a very good kickoff show. Made a change to actually to see a decent kickoff show.
Mm.
But then obviously when we go into WrestleMania itself, New Day opens it up.
Mm-hmm.
Of all the, did you hear the slight nudge to Xavier about the old Paige scandal, about pulling the levers? I thought that was fucking class.
Very well put.
Yes,
and it was so like
it was just enough hidden. Well, I say it was so discreet. Brilliant. Mm. The first match, if I'm right in saying, was Shane McMahon and AJ.
Yeah.
Brilliant opening match.
Oh, God. It was lovely. I wasn't expecting that to be the first match, though.
I didn't, actually. No, I expected something like the women's match or a SmackDown women's match or something like that. I didn't expect that one to be.
Mm.
But I think because it didn't have any title in involved, it was it was sort of like a last minute feud as well.
Yeah, it didn't have a lot of importance.
No, but no, it was a good match, and finishing off on SmackDown last night, AJ basically extended his hand and shook Shane's hand for that match, because it was a fucking good match.
It was a good match, and it also means that the feud doesn't have to continue. So we set it up for Mania, we did it at Mania, and now we can move on.
Yeah, exactly.
It was probably a filler thing.
Yeah, but it worked really well. And
the coast to coast back and forward thing. Oh, and
class.
It was like, who's going to pull it off? And
I mean, obviously AJ pulled out with a win on that one. I think we expected AJ to win that anyway.
Shane Lark's going over.
Yeah, Shane Lark's going over. I think as well, he's a very good commissioner. He knows how to, even though he's a good wrestler himself, he knows how to bring his stars up as well.
I beat the crap out of him.
Exactly. The next match. What was the next match? Because I haven't got these in order. These are my notes from last time. What was the next match?
I mean, I can't remember the complete order of 5 hours and 9 minutes, man. Jesus Christ.
Google. Come on, you get Google up. It's easier for you.
Oh, you want me to Google this? See, once again, those of you that may be watching news since James has found newfound fame on YouTube, we are not prepared.
We are never prepared. Never prepared. This is our statement. We are never prepared. Well done sorting this out.
I've just put we as well instead of WWE.
Well done. Well done sorting out. I'll just let everyone know. If you can see underneath, I'm doing a donation system for a company called Cash for Kids, who's based around Cumbria and southwest Scotland. They CFM radio, which is Cumbria FM radio, are asking 500 people to create a donation page and try and donate £100 within the year of 2017 for Cash for Kids. Cash for Kids is a fantastic charity. It helps support kids and families with kids with disabilities and things like that around Cumbria and southwest Scotland. The link is below, as you can see. But also as well, if you're watching this on, if you'd like to donate, if you're watching this on your computer, if you scroll down, you'll see a Cash for Kids button. Click on that, or if you're watching this on your phone or your tablet, click on the little eye in the top corner. It'll be in that corner there. And it'll come up with a window. You'll find the Cash for Kids button. Click on that. Donate anything you like. We're trying to raise £100 just for Cash for Kids. I say it's a fantastic charity, and I hope we can get that £100 for them. You found it, Dan?
We've got it.
You got it? Well, what was the next match?
Next match was Owens and Jericho.
Owens and Jericho for the US title.
Yes.
I think everyone wanted Jericho to win that, by the sound of that crowd.
he's quite liked in Orlando.
Well, he is, yeah. I did hear a lot of speculations, obviously, that Owens and Joe are teaming up.
Now,
I've heard a lot of things that apparently Triple H is going to be thinking about creating the new Evolution with him, Owens, and Samoa. Yeah. So I think that's why. I don't think people want to see that. Evolution.
I loved Evolution.
The original Evolution, yes. It's a bit like when the NWO came back, and it's a bit like when DX came back. I mean, I know that when DX came back, it was fucking hilarious, but it'll never be the same.
No.
Never be the same as the originals.
No.
You can create something accidentally and make it work perfectly,
but you try too hard.
Yeah, and you can't recreate. If you try to recreate it on purpose, it doesn't work. But anyway, that match itself, that was another great match. I think this is going to be a theme. Every match is brilliant.
This is for me. This is a theme, apart from maybe one.
Maybe one.
But
yeah.
This is a theme.
It's definitely a theme. I mean, it was just backwards and forwards. It was proper wrestling as well, which is what I liked. Yeah. I mean, that was the same with the beginning of the Shane and AJ match. It was actual wrestling.
It was proper wrestling.
No one expected Shane to actually wrestle.
No, that was a great thing. It was proper ground transition wrestling.
Yeah.
Your old school wrestling or your college wrestling or whatever.
Yeah, your amateur wrestling, yeah.
Yeah, amateur wrestling. Yeah, it was good. And then obviously we got the bit more ridiculous stuff at the end to make it more exciting and build it up. But
yeah.
It was a good match.
It was a good match, and I think Owens deserved to win the title, really. Because it's the only title he hasn't... It's one of the titles he hasn't held yet. I think they're trying to get Owens to be a bit like the new sort of Kurt Angle, try and get him into that region where he's got every title. He's had every title.
Yeah.
I mean, has he had the tag team? He hasn't had the tag team titles yet, has he?
He's had
the NXT title, he's had the Intercontinental title, he's had the WWE title, and the Universal title, and mm-hmm. now the US title. But no, he definitely deserves to win that. But I mean, it depends on now where he's going to go with his character now, doesn't it?
Yeah. Because are you getting bored of Owens?
I'm getting bored of him. Yeah, I'm getting bored of Owens' character. He needs to recreate his character, I think.
Yeah, I think it needs a new twist. It's a bit dry now.
Yeah.
He's a bit like Charlotte for me now.
Yeah, Charlotte's gone.
It's a bit like, oh God, can you just stop shouting?
Charlotte's gone a bit further than Owens, I think. Charlotte's gone stale.
Yeah. Yeah, Owens is just about starting to go off. You're starting to get a whiff of it.
Yeah.
You know, the cake's going a bit firm.
Yeah.
It's not as moist.
Nice.
I don't know what other analogies I can use.
He's mildly moist now.
Mildly moist. Yeah, he needs to change a little bit after Mania.
Next match.
It was the Fatal 4-Way Elimination match for the Raw Women's Championship.
Thank you, my darling. Bayley, Charlotte, Sasha, and Nia Jax.
Yeah.
Nia Jax being the first one to be eliminated. I think that was going to be predictable, actually, because what that kind of reminded me of was the Fatal 4-Way Elimination match back at WrestleMania 16, WrestleMania 2000, where Big Show was the first one to be eliminated.
Yeah,
it was kind of that sort of thing for me. So you had Nia Jax eliminated first. Obviously, she dominated at the start. Then they all team up on her. It was kind of exactly the same thing that happened back then. Then Sasha gets eliminated. I kind of wanted it to be Bayley and Sasha to be the last two, personally, myself.
Yeah, for the whole friendship thing.
Yeah, I reckon that would have worked better, but somehow Bayley pulls it off. God knows how she done that. I'm happy with that.
Fine with that.
Yeah.
And also, I like in that match that Nia's credibility hasn't been lost, because the only way she got eliminated or taken down was through three people.
Yeah.
So, exactly, you know, she may have gone first, but they haven't killed her credibility as to what she is.
Well, as I say, it was exactly the same with Big Show back in 2000. It took a mandible claw, a pedigree, and a people's elbow, and a rock bottom, to eliminate him.
Mm-hmm.
Bayley to win was just brilliant, because it stops that fight between Charlotte and Sasha.
Yeah,
it's now Bayley's Bayley's retained the title. It now moves on from there. Now, I'd like to see a feud now between Bayley and Nia for the title.
Yeah. But are they going to let Charlotte kind of wisp away into the distance? She's always gone back for a championship. She's always been, you know, only a couple of matches away from it.
I think what they've tried to do for Charlotte is try to get her as many title shots as possible to try and match her father's record in like the shortest time possible. I mean, she's five-time champion already.
She is five, yeah.
Yeah, she's five-time champion already, and this is only her second WrestleMania.
I mean, but that in the same way shows how the insanity of what they did. It we've said it so many times.
Yeah.
But I'm glad Bayley's got it.
Yeah, definitely.
Yay for Bayley.
Next.
Next was the Raw Tag Team Triple Threat.
Triple Threat. That was incredible. I had a feeling. You know when you get that feeling that something's going to happen?
Do you know what? I didn't, though.
I got that feeling. That's what I thought. I thought something's going to happen here. I don't know what, but something's going to happen. Then New Day's music hit. I thought, oh, for fuck's sake. And then they said, oh, this is now a Fatal 4-Way match. I'll piss off New Day. I mean, I love New Day, but come on, you're the host, you can't put yourself in. And then that music hit, and if that spot had a roof, it would have been blown off. I was jumping for fucking joy.
Christ, I was absolutely ecstatic.
For the Hardy Boys to make their return and that entire crowd shouting delete was incredible. The one thing I will say, though, I watched one of What Culture's videos. Shout out to What Culture. Obviously, they were over there for WrestleMania, and Adam was saying the one thing they've got to be careful of, obviously, obviously when Matt Hardy does the delete thing, he goes like that, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Obviously, when you're in the crowd, you can't do that because you'll knock out the person in front of you.
Correct.
So they've got to do that.
Oh, yeah.
You've got to be careful with that.
Yeah, a little, weren't you?
Yeah.
Also, you wouldn't want to start doing that and then have your entrance involving smoke or some form of mist, you know, like gas.
Oh, yeah. I can see where you're coming
from. This could go very wrong.
Especially you wouldn't yellow want to gas.
In a chamber match either.
Oh, no. and you. Yeah,
Elimination Chamber match. No, this is going really off key now.
Yeah, but the match itself was just... Oh,
and then Jeff did,
and fucked up, if you noticed that. One of the lads broke.
It was a little bit of a misplacement.
Yeah. I say, his legs caught it.
Yeah, his legs caught
it. I don't think it was enough pressure to snap that ladder.
Yeah.
But for them to win it as well, just made it even better.
Yeah, because it solidifies them to be back.
Well, I'll tell you what, though, they've done one
better. Because it could have been a while.
They done one better than the Dudleys, didn't they? Because the Dudleys came back to win it for the 10th time, and they didn't manage to get it done.
Yeah.
And for the Hardys to come and make their return and to win it on that same night as well. Well, yeah. And then on Raw they had their rematch against Gallows and Anderson, and still to retain, even better.
Yeah. Because every time they win shows that they ain't going nowhere yet. So
exactly,
is it going to be a Dudley Boys pop in for a few months and then see you later, or do we think that this contract
I reckon this contract has got the signature signed and sealed. Talking about contracts as well, I have heard as well, this has been confirmed that JR has actually signed a 2-year contract with WWE. It's not going to be a constant JR appearance. He's going to be, if they need him, he'll be there, sort of thing. He's still going to be signed with New Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he might make an appearance on every now and then pay-per-view, or even like the top four pay-per-view sort of thing. But it's
like
nice,
a part-time reserve.
Yeah, but it's nice to know that JR is back. That's the great thing on that one. But yeah, that tag team title match would just it summed it.
That set me off for the rest of it.
Oh yeah,
After that, I was so happy with that. I mean, God, they could have shit on everything else.
Exactly.
And to be fair, I probably still would have gone, what a pay-per-view. Yeah. And I know that's not right. You should never obviously say,
I mean, for a return of all returns, that was the best one I've seen in a long while.
Well, especially with all the Ring of Honor stuff going around.
Yeah. And I'd say they
stopped you from believing in any way.
I mean, because the greatest thing about it was the fact that it was all kept hush hush. They had their medicals, they'd signed their contract, they'd done everything without anyone knowing.
Yeah.
And that return, it was just as soon as it finished, I actually went on YouTube and I watched it again.
It was the surprise of it. It was very well done in the way of how it was hidden.
Mm-hmm.
And with the other rumours kicked in, no one thought it was going to happen.
No.
So that when it did, I mean...
It made it that much better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Better. Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Next?
Next was... Okay, so this is my one that I didn't particularly enjoy. It was the mixed tag team match.
Oh, yes, I forgot about this.
Which I'm pretty sure now was only set in place for one thing, and that was the after bit.
Yeah. Obviously, Cena and Nikki won.
Yes.
The match and itself it was a
very short.
The match itself wasn't that great. I will admit that. The proposal at the end, I'm happy for him.
Oh yeah, and it was
and nice. Did you and see the side of that fucking rock?
You see, you didn't quite get perspective in the box, but the moment it went on the finger and you saw this gleaming, massive...
You know, like, she's got, you know she got mugged after that, right?
I'm sure.
But the one thing I do like about that is the fact that he used her real name.
Yeah.
On the actual proposal itself, so you knew it was genuine.
Yeah.
One thing I want to know, did he wrestle with that in his pocket for the entire match?
Well, he didn't go nowhere. But that was why that match was short. But, I don't know.
Did he wrestle with it in his pocket, or was it given to him after the match when he went and got the bike? I'm not sure.
Well, you know, like, there you go.
Yeah. I ain't got a clue.
But well done for concealing it.
Oh yeah, definitely.
It made the missus cry. There you go.
Oh yeah, yeah. It was one of those moments.
She hasn't seen it yet,
but congratulations to John and Nikki. Yep. Anyway, obviously I think they're going to be taking some time out now.
Yeah, makes sense.
It does. Yeah. I mean, Cena needs to take time out. He's done too much. Recently.
Oh god, the bloke needs to give it a rest for a bit.
Yeah.
I mean, Christ, man, you've been going solid now for what, 12 years? Just give it
a rest. Yeah, about that, yeah. Next?
The non-sanctioned match.
Oh shit, yeah, I didn't write that down.
Yep, non-sanctioned match.
The non-sanctioned match, Seth and Triple H. What an entrance by Triple H.
Yeah, although he has been ribbed a bit for his little bike, his little trike.
It was a nice try, though.
It was a nice try, but very nice. Try.
But did you see them jeans that Stephanie was in?
It's just a moment of silence. Yeah. Anyway, yes. It was a good match.
It was a good match. There wasn't as much of the non-sanction rules that I thought was going to be a bit like. Because I thought it was going to be a bit like the Triple H Shawn Michaels SummerSlam unsanctioned match, chaotic.
Yeah.
It wasn't anything like that. There was a few chairs. The sledgehammer was used, obviously. There was a table used, obviously, but for none of the participants, obviously. Steph went through that.
I did laugh.
I did as well. But no, it was a good match.
It was a good match. It had a slight disappointment on it.
Hmm.
But yeah, it was good. I would have. I don't know. This is the problem with this sort of thing, is that are we still expecting something from the Attitude Era, or what the bloody hell have you done?
I've got a bottle opener stuck to my magnet on me.
Lovely. You better take that away from the battery. But yeah, are we still expecting Ruthless Aggression, Attitude Era type of matches when they come out with these sorts of non-sanctioned titles?
Yeah.
Are we never going to see that again? But they've done worse matches than that aren't non-sanctioned, so it was a bit of a letdown. But
I say it was a bit of a letdown because the fact of the matter is there wasn't many outlandish matches, different match stipulations in this whole WrestleMania. The only one we had really was the ladder match.
Yeah.
Rest of them were all tag team matches or single matches.
Mm-hmm.
So I was a bit disappointed at the fact that there wasn't like a proper OMG moments in that.
Well, there was more OMG moments in AJ and Shane.
Exactly, yeah.
And that was the first match of the night for the main. WrestleMania.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was. But anyway.
But no, it was a good match, and for Seth to win it as well, with the injury as well, made it all the better.
Yep.
Really.
Yep.
Obviously, he's now been claimed as the Kingslayer.
And he's now a lover boy for the universe, so everyone loves
exactly.
him now.
Yeah. I think I know what the next match was. The next match was for the WWE title.
No, you're missing.
Am I missing one?
You are missing.
Which one?
You're forgetting the women. You're being sexist.
That was after. It was after the WWE title match. Because this is what I said to you. That's what I said to you. Yeah, when we watched the Bray and Orton match, I realised we still had three matches afterwards.
Touché, sir.
Thank you. So for the WWE title, Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton, that was a weird match.
Yeah.
What was with the projections of the maggots and snakes and things like that all in the ring?
Oh, they were very nice and gruesome.
They were good, but I didn't understand it.
But then, why... why do all of that, right? Why give Bray a title for, 1 month?
Yeah,
about you give him all the projections, you give him all of the limelight in that match, and then he loses?
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong.
The RKO out of nowhere caught everyone by surprise.
Yeah.
But...
most of the time. That's,
yeah. But I'll say, if you're gonna push Bray in that way, why strip him from the belt?
The credibility at the end.
Exactly. It should have been a way of, I'm playing the mind game. I'm playing the mind games here. This is how I win.
Yeah, and Orton's hasn't for a very long time been known for the mind games.
Mm.
Or any of that. And Bray has more of the mind games.
Yeah.
And his little shack was burnt down, so he would have technically had more of the ruthless kind of wanting to win, and it just, the end didn't seem right. It didn't feel right.
Exactly, yeah. But no, it was a good match, and I mean, Orton winning it as well. It sums Orton up as... He's defeated the Eater of Worlds, if you want to put it that way.
Yeah.
But then obviously,
I don't think he's going to hold that title for very long.
No, but then obviously last night there was the return of Eric Rowan last night on SmackDown, and then there was a tag team match with Orton and Harper versus Bray and Rowan. I don't know who won that. I didn't actually see who won that. Because SmackDown was the only one I haven't actually watched. I watched Raw, that was good. Then we come on to the SmackDown Women's title.
Yes.
This caught us off by surprise, really, because I didn't actually realise it was going to be a six-way match.
No.
The way they described the match, it was going to be, we thought it was going to be a gauntlet match or something like that. And for it to be a six-way was a bit weird.
Yeah, and to be honest, I didn't know all the way up until Alexa Bliss's end, or the end of Alexa Bliss's entrance.
Mm-hmm.
I was still wondering why she was walking down that extremely long ramp. We haven't mentioned that yet.
85-yard ramp.
Massive ramp. I mean, you literally, I'll tell you what, I know why it went over by an hour, because we had to wait for everyone to get down that fucking ramp.
Well, if you watch the kickoff show on the Battle Royale, pretty much all everyone apart from Big Show and Braun Strowman, they all came down together.
It was,
and I like the fact
I've ever seen a ramp that big.
I like the fact as well that they popped Undertaker up halfway down, because it would have took fucking 4 hours to walk down the fucking thing.
I did turn to the missus and went, we're going to be waiting a while when his music hit, because I thought, oh good god, if they're going to make him walk all the way down, we'll be hearing his music, which is
I mean it was long enough anyway. Can you imagine if he had to walk from the top of it?
It's huge.
Just going back to that ramp, what I did like about it is the fact that the graphics that they put on that ramp for every single superstar.
Oh yeah, the snake following Orton.
The snake following Orton.
And I will admit, Reigns's was good. The sparks down.
Yeah, the sparks down it, and Seth with the flaming with the torch. Flame. Yeah, and basically setting the whole thing on fire. I thought that was really good. No, the graphics on the graphics and the pyro and the actual whole setup for WrestleMania. I love that massive ring on the top.
Yeah.
That was incredible.
It was some fantastic pyro. They had the best fireworks as well. Yeah. They had everything.
I did see a tweet. I was on Twitter all night while watching Mania, because Nerdcube was on watching it as well and tweeting at the same time. And he put the funniest tweet on I have ever seen. It basically said, it was after Charlotte made her entrance, and he said, right, Charlotte gets a full firework display, you watch when Becky comes out, she'll have a sparkler.
Yeah. And she didn't even get that.
No.
She got some smoke, as per usual.
As per usual, that was about it, yeah. Yeah, I thought that was fucking hilarious. But for all people to win, I never expected Naomi to win.
Do you know what?
And I'm happy.
Somewhere back here, there was like, okay, they've been pushing her for it for the second time, and Orlando.
Yeah,
and it clicked.
It was in her own hometown.
It clicked about halfway through, and I was like, yeah, hang on a minute.
She was in her own hometown.
They're going to do this.
The amount of, when we actually, after we, after obviously in the next match anyway, the amount of title changes.
Oh God, they were incredible.
Hang
what
on,
do we have? We have the title.
Hang on, hang on. There's five title changes.
Yeah, all bar one.
Yeah.
Which was Bayley.
So there was six titles. Oh, and the IC title. So seven titles. Seven titles. Two of them didn't change hands.
Yeah. That's a big change. Big change for story as well.
Yeah,
actually,
exactly.
Now that we're speaking about this and it's put in some perspective.
Well, I say we can continue talking about this with the next match, which is the Universal title match.
Mm-hmm.
Goldberg versus Lesnar. Have to admit, the best Goldberg-Lesnar match.
Oh, God, yeah.
I mean, obviously, the Survivor Series match was just unexpected. No one expected
it. Yeah, it was a shock.
But this was a good match. Because
this was F5s and spears, and
it was brutal. It was backwards and forwards.
Mm.
I mean,
and it was just a power match.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, and I'm glad it lasted more than 1:20.
Yeah, I think it was still under 5 minutes.
I reckon it could have gone longer. I would have been happy if it went longer, personally, because it's one of the matches which would have been better if it had got longer. Because it would have been suspense on, oh, he's kicked out of another F5, he's kicked out of another
spear. Yeah, it hit a stage of, you know, we got into our whole Suplex City moment. And
10 suplexes
it was from there
the
on
end.
That it kind of ended.
Yeah, I say 10 suplexes in the end.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I think it would have been better if it had that suspense of, that's been like the third F5 he's kicked out of that, that's like the fourth spear he's kicked out of that.
Yeah, we want the finishers.
Yeah, like the third jackhammer. Oh, he's kicked out of the third jackhammer.
Yeah,
the only person ever to kick out of more than two jackhammers.
I mean, we didn't want it to go too long.
No,
we didn't want it to kind of get boring. But I mean, do you know what my favourite bit was?
Go on.
Was after Lesnar had started first and kicked out the bat first, and the cameraman's obviously wrong anyway. And he's got it kind of top body on Brock, and so you just see him go, whoa, hey, out! It's just, oh, there was a spear there somewhere.
Just out of nowhere, just Goldberg just comes out of nowhere and just spits fuck out of him.
And it was just, that bit in my own, in itself, was just like, holy shit, like, this is going to be brutal.
But obviously, we knew Lesnar was going to win it because Goldberg's, I think Goldberg's had enough.
Yeah.
Although, did you by chance see Raw Talk?
No.
I watched Raw, then I flicked onto WWE Network after that, watched a bit of Raw Talk, because after Raw finished, Goldberg came down to the ring. Basically, he did a heartwarming send-off. He invited his son into the ring, who made his very first botch of his career. He jumped over the barricade and fell on his ass.
Yeah.
Poor sod.
Also, he's getting used to the idea of fucking up, so that's good.
Yeah. Even Goldberg said he's taking more hits than me already.
Yeah.
But he made this great speech. He did a mic drop. Then he picked the mic back up again and he said, never say never.
Mm.
could we see Goldberg back?
Yes, but in a match setting? I don't know.
Exactly. I mean,
there could be coming back for Brock at some point further down the line. But
he could come back for Brock. He could come back for someone else. You don't know.
Yeah, but I don't know if I want it.
No, I think this one time sort of title run, obviously with him being in 2K17 and things like that, it helped.
Yeah, plus we've got a new game being made now, so Goldberg needs to, like, yeah.
Well, obviously, I think obviously we know who's going to be in this next game. Obviously, it's going to be Angle.
Mm-hmm.
Which is great.
Yeah.
We move on to the main event.
Yeah.
Undertaker versus Roman Reigns.
us have lost a big bet, have we? Because
if no one was watching the last stream, you'd be able to catch it on my YouTube channel. Dan, originally we did this stipulation for Survivor Series.
I think it was Survivor. I think it was after Survivor.
It might have been after Survivor Series. It was Fastlane. It was fast. No, not Fastlane. It was Fastlane.
I think. Have I survived it twice? Or?
You survived it twice now. Yes. No, you survived it twice. You survived it twice? No, you survived it once.
Once.
Yeah. Because it was for Fastlane. Dan has got a little bottle of homemade hot sauce he got from a work colleague. And on Fastlane, he predicted if Kevin Owens lasted longer than Brock Lesnar, he was going to down this hot sauce. Obviously, he didn't.
Mm-hmm.
So he managed to survive. On our prediction WrestleMania stream, he stipulated if Roman Reigns beats Taker, he will down this hot sauce.
Mm.
Quick question for you, though, before we move on to the hot sauce stipulation.
Yeah.
Also, our friend Dan Barton said that if Roman Reigns wins, he will cancel his WWE Network subscription. Is he doing that?
This is to be confirmed. I'm seeing him tomorrow, so I will bring it up with him in person, and we will find out if he's going to do it. I mean, I know also many YouTubers, obviously, What Culture Wrestling and others are like, that also do predictions and all this sort of thing. They set out their own dares, and a lot of them have lost those. Yep. So, I mean, the whole world has been affected, really. But
I mean, we won't do your stipulation just yet. We'll do that at the end of the stream.
Yeah,
because you need to talk.
I generally don't know the power of this.
I mean, if it just show on camera the size of this.
This is it, I mean, that's
about the same size as one of them little jars of marmalade that you can get in like a hotel sort of thing.
To put it in perspective, here's the shot glass I'll be drinking it out of, and we're talking probably two-thirds of a shot, maybe a bit less than that.
Yeah,
but
have you got your Superman shot glass because you think you're going to survive this? Or is it going to be a bit like kryptonite to you?
I don't know sure, because we do have this just in case. So we don't really know how strong it is. Mm. I don't know what my reaction
will be. Do you know what it's actually made with?
Honestly, no, I didn't ask, because it would frighten the life out of me. It definitely has seeds. It has some forms of herb in it as well, so I'm hoping it'd be nicely flavoured.
What's the smell?
The smell is ridiculous. So, as we know, I stipulated this first time round and I won. So I have had this sat there, unopened, for...
Since Fastlane.
So now when you smell it, it burns nostrils. I mean, it has brewed. It's definitely stronger than
what it was. So if you'd like to see that, make sure you stay in stream and watch that. Because that is going to be something to watch. What I will do while we talk about this last match, I will send out a message on Facebook saying that you are going to do this. The match itself, what did you think about the Taker Romans match itself?
Okay, so I'm going to be quite controversial here. So, initial reaction, I was fuming.
Yep.
I was really angry. I couldn't believe that as Taker's last match they did that. And the fact that they allowed Reigns to have a display at the end, and it was all infuriating me. When I calmed down, mm-hmm. and I kind of got some perspective on the whole pay-per-view and everything in general, I can accept how that match ended, because the match itself was a good one. It wouldn't have been a fact of Taker, you know, Taker was happy obviously for this to be the way it worked, and that makes me happy for the way it worked. He still got his bit afterwards, and I'm starting to understand what they're doing with Reigns now to a point. At least I think I do.
Yeah.
No one likes him, and they are playing that like a fucking flute.
Yes.
And I just realised that a bad reaction is just as powerful, if not more, than a good reaction to someone, and this just heightens that reaction. It keeps you wanting to hate him, and I do get it now.
Yeah. Did that post? Was this posting? Have you had a notification on your phone? Because I have tagged you in that.
Not yet, but continue. Yet. Your thoughts, sir.
My thoughts. It was a good match.
There you go.
It has posted, has it?
Yes, yeah.
All right, because if you look on that, it's still going round and round. Mm. Look, have a look at that. It's definitely there. It's still there. Right. Yeah. Okay. Hang on. Let me just. We'll be with you one second. Yes, it has. Yes, it was a good match. It has basically shown how much of a dick Roman really is. But it's brought it has turned him heel, which is what everyone wants.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah.
The amazing thing that I loved about that match was the aftermath of the match. The fact that Taker got himself back in his coat and his hat. He then took off his gloves, took off his coat, took off his hat, laid them in the ring, and they were still there when the ring crew was dismantling. They left them untouched while they were dismantling that ring. And obviously, obviously this stream has now, it's got hashtag thank you Taker on this stream. And you have to admit, after nearly a 27-year career, he's going in the Hall of Fame next year. It's obvious.
It's sad.
Yeah.
Never wanted it to be.
It's an era, obviously for both of us and for everyone else sort of our age and a bit older and things like that. It's an era that has come to an end. Is WWE going to be the same? Is it going to be?
I think it actually will, because Taker, over the last few years, we've all been speculating about him retiring each year for the last five, I think. Mm-hmm. And he has only appeared once a year.
Yeah,
you know, maybe twice.
I mean, I
don't think him leaving is necessarily going to affect too much.
No, I did see apparently he's actually going under surgery.
Yeah,
now.
Yeah, I saw that as well.
But I mean, because his health is just ridiculous.
You could see it at the end.
Yeah,
you could after everything was off.
Yeah.
And he kind of broke kayfabe a little bit.
He definitely broke character. It's the first time ever on live TV that he's ever broke character. Obviously, when he went over and saw his, went and kissed his wife.
Yeah.
And the way it ended as well, the fact that he went back up that ramp, he put his arm up as he normally does. Everyone in the crowd did exactly the same thing.
Yep.
And how he just.
And he just dropped.
It was brilliant. Great way to end it.
Yeah.
And
I'm really happy with how it ended.
And moving on from that to Monday Night Raw. the opening credits to Monday Night Raw. It didn't have the traditional credits. It did like the photos from that match. Then it went three or four minutes of the entire crowd chanting Undertaker. Then it sort of faded out into Undertaker into Roman sucks. I have to admit, this was one of the best promos ever. In fact, when it went into Roman sucks, Roman music hits, he walks into the ring and there's just 10 minutes of booing.
Yes.
Booing, fuck you Roman, yep. Roman sucks, you're an asshole.
Yeah.
Everything. It was class, and all he has to say is five words. This is my yard now. Mic drop, yeah. Walk out. Perfect.
Good God. But this is the thing, though. This is why I get it. I now get it. I get what they're doing with Reigns. And to be honest, I don't. I still hate him, but I hate him differently now. I hate him with respect.
It's been the longest heel turn, I think, ever.
Yeah.
And it's worked. Now how it's done, how he's actually fully turned. When you think about it now, it's worked so well.
It makes a whole lot more sense now.
Yeah.
All the times on all of the streams we've done where we've hated him.
Yeah.
And we haven't even realized we have been drawn in to this plan.
Yeah.
And hats off to him, and as I say, I now have a hatred of him that I respect him, because he's obviously, I'm pretty sure, right, you know, if he broke kayfabe, he didn't like necessarily what he had to do. He probably saw it as an honour that he got to do that match and, and to win it.
Well, he did. Well, apparently he didn't know he was going to win until he was about to walk through that curtain. Taker said to him, "You've got to do it." Just as he was about to walk out on that out onto that stage, he didn't know he was going to win. And respect to Taker for basically trusting Reigns into ending his career.
Yeah.
And it was just the match itself was. I mean, there was a video, it was like a cartoon I saw on Facebook, I think it was from Sportkeeda that done it. Every Superman punch, every spear that Roman did took away one of Undertaker's losses, one of Undertaker's wins, sorry, from Mania. What he was doing, every time he got hit, there was a ghost coming out of him of a specific superstar that he had beaten at WrestleMania, and I think that's what it was. He was getting weaker and weaker through every punch, every spear.
Yeah, and he kind of, you know, he got up and he kind of just rocked down.
Yeah,
and
it was
sad to watch, but there was a lot of power behind all.
Yeah, it was very emotional, and it was a great way to end it, really, and a great way to end a brilliant WrestleMania.
Yeah,
and
stunning, exquisite.
Yeah, and it rolled on into Raw the following night, which it always does. I think it sort of faded with SmackDown last night.
Yeah, SmackDown didn't show too much interest.
It had been a long weekend, obviously, from Friday, obviously from the Hall of Fame into NXT, into Mania, into Raw. That's four shows there. Then they got SmackDown after that, and then into 205 Live after that as well.
It's a big time for all of them, and they must be fucking exhausted.
Yeah, but a whole WrestleMania weekend was just absolutely stunning.
Yeah,
you couldn't fault it.
No, not really. There are things that we didn't like per se. There's things that we don't understand, as we've discussed. But when you look at it as a whole package, that was
flawless.
Yeah, it was.
And we've already been confirmed a match for Payback, a rematch for the US title.
Yeah.
For Jericho and Owens. I reckon we're going to get a decent feud with them two now.
Yeah. And it's like, with so many title changes, this opens up a lot of new feuds or whatever. We don't know, but it definitely opens up the slate and the table.
But what about as well some of the returns and debuts on Raw and SmackDown? Obviously, we've got a new GM.
Yeah.
In Kurt Angle. Who'd have thunk it?
But did we say
we did predict this? I did hear rumours about this, they turned out to be true. It was nice to see Vince there as well to actually to introduce that. I love the fact that everyone cheered when he was saying that Stephanie's not going to be there because she went for a fucking table. That was hilarious. We got the debut of the Revivals. Great tag team from NXT. Obviously we had the return to Raw of the Hardy Boys, who retained the titles. Then obviously we also had the return of Emma as well on Raw, which is good to see, because I think she's better off as Emma than she was as Emelina.
Emelina was a bit
Then obviously on SmackDown last night, Nakamura made his debut. I'm so happy about that.
You are a Nakamura fan.
I am a big Nakamura fan. He does look very pissed every time he comes into the ring, though. He does look very a bit sort of droopy eyed and high off his rocker, but he's such a fantastic wrestler.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, he's an amazing wrestler. I'm not gonna hang about anymore. You're gonna down that shit, boy.
Alright, okay.
Come on, bring it on for the viewers.
So,
the viewers we have in.
You know, your likes, your shares, your subscribes, all of this sort of thing.
Yep.
For this sort of thing.
This will be getting, if anything does go wrong, this will be getting a warning before I put it on YouTube. Don't you worry about that. Is it good? Were you trying to put that under the camera for me to smell? Yeah, that looks good.
Alright, here you go. Hold that up while I'm just putting this down. Just show.
Yeah.
Right, okay, so.
Okay. Bottoms up, boy.
Bottoms up, I suppose.
Is it good?
Say something.
No.
Fuck. No, I won't. We're going to finish this stream. I ain't going to take a drink.
No. Is it good?
Oh, shit. I'll tell you what, I won't taste anything for a week. And my arse is going to be burning tomorrow at work.
I should have got you them wipes.
Yeah, I need some arse wipes.
What did it taste like?
I have got a word. Bear in mind, everyone. We've done this on a weekday, obviously. I can barely talk, mate. My throat has just gone... So I do have to do an 8 till half 4 shift tomorrow. With God knows what happens in here.
What did it taste of? Just pure heat?
It's pure heat, mate. I couldn't taste a thing. And it's right on my tongue now. My lips have gone completely...
Have they gone completely numb?
And I can feel it about here, right now. And my glands have just gone. Boom. So, if I'm over the initial heat, it's not, don't get me wrong, this isn't like ghost chili or anything like that, guys, so don't.
That's a shame.
But, initial heat's gone, I just really can't talk right now.
Will the gentleman who made this be getting a slap tomorrow?
Gentleman, it was a female.
Okay.
and because of that, no, I will not slap, but I will definitely be letting them know there's some good hot sauce.
You have to ask her to get us another one. I'll have some next time you see us.
It is quite hot.
Yeah.
Shit.
So you don't want that. Bloody hell, you'd kill yourself. You'd set yourself on fire if you did that.
Every time I cough, I just taste the fucking...
Yeah, I've got menthol in this one. Do you want some of that?
I literally just dropped 2 levels of puberty as well. Just... Yeah.
Right. Your eyes are watering there.
Carry on.
Yeah. I think that'll do for WrestleMania weekend. We'll be back with the we'll be back in a couple of weeks' time for predictions on Payback. I think it's at the end of the month, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's really soon.
It's at the end of April. So we'll be back in a couple of weeks' time for that. Don't worry, guys. I haven't forgotten about uploading actual videos to YouTube. I just haven't had any time whatsoever recently. I will be getting some views. I am very, very, very close to getting my 1,000 subscribers. I will just have a look now, see what we're on. We are on 988. there we go. 988 is backwards. I can't help that. 988 subscribers, so we're very, very close. So I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who subscribed, really. Once we hit that 1,000 mark, it would just be incredible. I have got a few mystery box, well, mystery egg videos to do. So I will be getting them on. I did record one the other week, but for some reason I recorded it on my phone, but it's gone into vertical mode, which is quite annoying. So I will have to record another one, because I can't get it swapped. I can't swap it to horizontal mode, which is really annoying. But we will be getting. I will be getting some more videos on, and hopefully, how's your? You're all right.
I'm all right. Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah. I'm just riding through a sea of hot.
Okay, how's things going with your channel?
Yeah, good. So for those that don't know, I have a laptop, hence why I shake around a lot from time to time, and I'm using the webcam on it, which means I'm always looking really shit.
Yeah, I'll just interrupt you there briefly. There was one time where Dan's camera actually cut out, his whole laptop actually restarted live on stream, and I Skyped him via his phone, and his phone actually had a better camera than his laptop.
So thanks, Samsung, for your S7.
Yes.
Yeah, but I don't have a good computer for, obviously, for me to do this YouTube channel with my friend. I need a computer. I'm going to need quite a powerful one, one that can hold all videos and all sort of malarkey. So that's quite an expensive ordeal. That has currently been delayed. Car and things has cost money. But we are looking at sorting out a startup, a few vids at around theirs, at her house, and we're going to get this kicked off. And, you know, obviously once we've really got it going, hopefully I should be able to get my own computer and we'll set up. But yes, we are going to start.
I say, and don't worry as well, there were, obviously for Dan and, is it Cassie, is it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
For Dan and Cassie actually starting up their YouTube channel, I will be helping them out as well to try and get their views, their subscribers up. We'll be doing some collaboration stuff as well. I will be helping them out that way, because I'd like to see someone. I know what it's like, obviously, fully starting it off, and it's a bitch. When you're getting like one or two views on a video, it sucks. But obviously, I will be giving you guys a hand as well, and I'll give you some little tips. But thank you guys for watching. This will be going, being uploaded into YouTube as well, thankfully the stream did not drop out this time.
It didn't drop out.
I don't know if anyone was there in the pre-predictions video, but my internet was fucking up like no one's business. I actually had an engineer come out to sort out my line, but while we were in stream, it actually cut the stream out halfway through, and that's why it's in two videos, two parts on YouTube, because it cut out on us and it was a pain in the fucking ass.
Yeah, the quality on that video is probably not good either.
The Skype quality was terrible. There was a point.
That's watched that video, we apologise.
I've had over 400 views on part two on that video, the problem we had with it was obviously with the internet cutting out, the Skype quality was really, 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 really shoddy. There was a point where Dan was about 4 or 5 seconds behind me.
Yeah, there was some lag.
Yeah, definitely some lag. But one thing we need to do, me and you, stop panting. We need to do some videos again ourselves of actual gaming, I think.
After my tongue's come back.
I think a Battlefield video will be quite good.
Yeah, I'm shit at it, as most of these things, but yeah, we could do that.
Yep, do a Battlefield video. I know Barton wants to do a Rocket League video as well. I think that would do a Rocket League stream, or we can get back into GTA as well, do a few races on that. But yeah, so thank you guys for joining. We'll be back in a couple of weeks for Payback. And thank you very much, Dan.
Thank you very much, mate.
Make sure your tongue gets better.
Need some water.
Cheers, guys. See you now. Ta-da.
See you there. Ta-da.